Hello friends, today plant pathology basics part 3 video. If you didn't subscribe our channel, click the subscribe button and press the bell icon, okay? If you didn't watch previous 2 videos regarding basics in plant pathology, please watch it, it will be useful. For any queries regarding plant pathology and what type of questions you need, what type of topics I need to explain, please comment in comment section. I need to know how many of them are watching. This topic is classification of plant diseases, okay? Actually, plant diseases are classified in different ways. In this video, I'm going to explain the important classifications and major classifications you need to know, okay? Everyone know the classification of plant disease, that is viral disease, bacterial disease, and root disease, everything. These are common things you know. But in this video, I'm going to explain as a plant pathologist what are the major classifications you need to know and how they will ask questions and how they will ask objective questions and what are the important things and what are the key points you need to know regarding the classification of plant disease. I'm going to explain in this video, okay? See various classification based on effect, okay? First classification is based on type of infection. Plant diseases are classified into localized diseases and systemic diseases, okay? Localized diseases are nothing but, that is the disease infection is in a particular part of the plant, okay? The key point is a particular part of the plant. The disease infected area is particular part of the plant, that's all. It is a localized disease. And systemic disease is nothing but, almost whole plant is affected, okay? That is a systemic disease, okay? Key point to be noted is, localized disease means particular part of the plant. Systemic disease means almost whole part of the plant, okay? And coming to the examples for localized diseases, leaf spot and anthracnose, okay? And this leaf spot affects particular part of the plant, that is leaf only, that's why it is a localized disease, okay? And coming to the examples for systemic diseases, that is downy mildew of Bajra, which is caused by Cercospora graminicola, and smut and viral diseases, etc. Some examples for systemic diseases, okay? And you can see in these pictures carefully, this is leaf spot. It is example for what? Localized disease, okay? And it is a green ear head symptom, that is downy mildew of Bajra or pear millet. Almost whole plant is affected in this disease. That's why it is a systemic disease, okay? Based on mode of spread, the diseases are classified as airborne disease, seed-borne disease, soil-borne disease and vector-borne disease, okay? And note on the examples for this disease, that is airborne disease, the mode of spread is by air, that is Urtica leaf spot of groundnut, which is caused by Mycosparilla arachidis or Cercospora arachidicola or Cercospora personata. And seed-borne disease is loose mud of wheat. That is Ustilago nudatitis. It is an internally seed-borne disease. Very, very important and frequently asked question. Loose mud of wheat is internally seed-borne disease. Okay. And soil-borne disease is example. Root rot of pulses. It is caused by Macrofomina fasolina. It is also very important disease. And vector-borne disease. Every viral diseases are mostly vector-borne disease. Okay. That is rice tungro virus, which is transmitted by green leaf hopper. That is loose mud of wheat, which is caused by Ustilago nudatitis. It is an internally seed-borne disease. It is a frequently asked question. Please take a note on it and note down the examples. From examples only, most of the objective questions are asked, okay? And based on occurrence and geographical distribution, it is very important, okay? And many questions are asked and many objective questions will be asked from this classification only. First is endemic disease. This disease is prevalent or confined to particular country or district, okay? Example is club root of cabbage, which is confined to Nilgiris in Tamil Nadu and it is caused by Plasmodifora brassicae. And the wart disease of potato, it is caused by Centricum endobiaticum and it is confined to Darjeeling in West Bengal, okay? Endemic is nothing but, the key point here is, the disease is prevalent or confined to particular country or district, okay? It is a definition, epidemic or epiphytic disease, okay? It is nothing but, the definition is sudden outbreak of disease. It is called epidemic or epiphytic disease, okay? The example is wheat stem rust and late blight of potato. Wheat stem rust, there are three types, that is a black rust, brown rust and the yellow rust. About that, we will study detailing in another video while studying the diseases. And late blight of potato is caused by Phytophthora infestans. These are epidemic disease. These diseases are occurred due to sudden outbreak, and they caused various losses and devastating loss they gave. Okay, coming to the sporadic disease, the definition and key point for diseases: the disease spreads by irregular intervals. Okay, that is the disease spread by irregular intervals. Examples to be noted: Udbata disease of rice, which is caused by Aphis oryzae, and sugarcane mosaic virus disease, and Fusarium wilt of cotton. These are the important examples for sporadic disease. The key point to be noted is the disease occur at irregular intervals. Coming to the pandemic disease, a disease is said to be pandemic when it is prevalent throughout the country, continent, or world, involving mass mortality. Example is late blight of potato caused by Phytophthora infestans. Okay, it is very important point. And coming to the classification based on multiplication of inoculum, it is classified by Van der Planck in 1963. Who is Van der Planck? He is a father of epidemiology. Okay, note it down. And he classified as simple interest and compound interest disease based on multiplication of inoculum. What is simple interest disease? It is mathematically analog to simple interest in money, caused by monocyclic pathogen with low birth rate and only one generation. Okay, that is pathogen produces spores at very slow rate, incubation and sporulation period is long, and the curve is saturation curve. It is very important, and examples are very important and frequently asked. Example for simple interest diseases: loose mud of wheat, wilt and root rot. Okay, loose mud of wheat is a internally seed borne disease, and it is also simple interest disease. Okay, and these are the examples. Right, take a note on example and curve also they will ask. You can see the saturation curve for monocyclic disease or simple interest disease in this picture. Next, compound interest disease. This is mathematically analog to compound interest money, and it is a polycyclic disease. It is caused by polycyclic pathogen which is having high birth rate, that is pathogen produces spores at rapid rate, and these diseases have several generations. Incubation and sporulation period is short, and the curve here is sigmoid curve. Okay, don't confuse, it is a sigmoid curve. Examples are rust, powdery mildew and downy mildew. You can see the sigmoid curve of polycyclic disease. Okay, that's all about major classification of plant disease and important classifications. If you didn't subscribe our channel, click the subscribe button, and please share this video with your friends who are all preparing. Okay, and thank you. Telegram channel link is in description box, you can join. Study well, all the best, and prepare well, share with your friends. Thank you.